has one more statement in Luke that I want to add. And that's how you need to forgive him even if he turns to you seven times. I know that later on in Matthew, after he speaks about the steps for rebuking someone, in verse 18 he repeats what he said in chapters earlier, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Verse 19, if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that shall be asked, it shall be done for them, which is in heaven. Verse 20, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in the midst of them. And then verse 21, Peter says, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive them? Till seven times. He asks the question, should I really forgive him seven times? And Jesus responds, I say not to you until seven times, but until 70 times seven. So the question comes from Luke, where should this go? If he trespass against you seven times in a day, and seven times in a day turn to you again, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. Because if I put that before Peter asks the question, it would seem as if that question was already answered. If Jesus says, if he trespass against you seven times, and turn and repent to you again, you shall forgive him. It wouldn't make sense to then have Peter ask the question, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till seven times? And Jesus says no. I don't quite think it would make sense after. Because after Peter asks this question, Jesus says, I say not to you until seven times. So if I have first Peter ask the question, I could go right into Jesus' words here in Luke. And if he trespass against you seven times in a day, and seven times a day return to you again, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. Then I can continue with Jesus' words from Matthew. I say not to you until seven times, but until 70 times seven. So until means what's the limit? Peter's asking for where can I finally stop forgiving him? So Jesus' response could be first to Peter's question, if he comes to you seven times, forgive him that seven times, and then he could add at the end from Matthew, don't just stop there. Go all the way until 70 times seven. Or in reality, just keep on forgiving him if he keeps coming back and repents. So that's one way. I could put Peter's question, all of Jesus' response, saying, if he returns, forgive him seven times. But then don't just stop there, keep on forgiving him. Or I could have Jesus' words from Luke come next after what I have here. If he shall hear you and repent, you have gained your brother, forgive him. Now I could put these words from Luke 17, and if he trespass against you seven times in a day, and seven times in a day return again to you, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. I could have that, and then flow into when he doesn't repent, Matthew 18, 16, but if he will not hear you, then take one or two witnesses. Then Jesus' other words, what you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Where two are gathered, I am in the midst of them. Then Peter's question. But see, that might be confusing because Jesus had already said yes seven times. If I put that first. I don't think that way works. So I think the first way I mentioned is the best. Peter asks the question. Jesus first says, yes, forgive him seven times, and then he says, not until seven times, meaning don't stop there. 70 times 7. And it might seem confusing because he does say, yes, forgive him 7 times, and then I'm going to go right into 22, I say not to you until 7 times. It's as if he's just doing away with what he said, but if you look at it a different way, Peter asks, should I actually forgive him 7 times? Or till 7 times, right? Jesus answers, yes, forgive him that many. And don't stop there. Not just until, but all the way until 70 times 7. So I think that's the best way to see it. Peter's question first, then Jesus, both his responses from Luke first and then Matthew. Which means that I'm going to continue with Matthew. What happens if your brother will not hear you? And this is only in Matthew. But he will not hear you. Then take with you one or two more. And if he shall neglect to hear them, tell it to the church. But if he neglect to hear the church, let him be to you as a heathen man and a publican. Whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. Now Peter comes before Jesus and asks the question, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till 7 times. And Jesus' first response that I can put here, I'm going to put from Luke, forgive him 7 times. And then not just 7 times, keep going. So then I can have Jesus says to him. From Luke, however, and if he trespass against you 7 times. That and I think I might have to leave out because it doesn't quite fit. Or I can move it to the end. So it just begins with Jesus saying, if he trespassed against you 7 times in a day and 7 times again turn to you again, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. Then, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put the and at the end. That way it's, and I say not to you until 7 times, but until 70 times 7. Yeah, so I'll save the and. But I will have Jesus beginning to respond, which is Jesus says to him, now going to Luke, if he trespass against you 7 times in a day, and 7 times in a day turn again to you, saying, I repent, you shall forgive him. Now the end from the beginning of the verse and back to Matthew. I say not until 7 times, until 70 times 7.